Hi friends, this is the lecture number 12. This is a very important lecture for you, okay? That is very important, okay? Here I will again explain you that I will solve two or three questions, okay? That will clear your concept, okay? Just listen, pause every time the video, again listen. Okay, if you are facing any problem, then ask me. So he is asking, he has given something, then after he is asking, again I will tell you that please follow the lecture number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 9, 10, 11, then come here, okay. So he is asking what is the range of T, what is the range null space of T. T means transformation, linear transformation. Actually this is the function, okay. We are transforming some elements from here to here, okay. That is the meaning of T, okay. So now he has given us that T x1 x2 is equal to, okay, you are getting such type of result, okay. So that is the output, that is the input, okay. It means that this x1 x2 it is here, and after then you are getting x1 comma x2 actually, okay. Then you are getting this result, x1 plus x2 comma x1 minus x2 comma x2, okay. So it means that this is r3 and this is r2, okay. That is a two dimensional. By the help of T we are converting two dimensional to three dimensional, okay. This is the meaning. So now he is asking what is the range of T, what is the null space of T. Already in the lecture number 11 I explained you range means null means how many element are going to zero, that is the null space. And how many elements it is mapping, okay, that is the range, okay. So now how to find the null space and this, okay. At first I will find the null space. Null space means how many elements are going to zero. So let this element, it is going to 0 0 0, okay. If this is going to 0 0 0, it means that this is equal to 0, this is equal to 0, this is equal to 0. So it implies that x1 plus x2 is equal to 0, and after then x1 minus x2 is equal to 0, and third one is x2 is equal to 0. If x2 is equal to 0, it implies that x1 is equal to 0. If x1 x2 is equal to 0, it implies that only t 0 0 is going to 0 0 0. If x both are 0, then you know that that is 0 0 0. It means that only one element it is going to 0 0, sorry, only 0 0 identity is going to identity. So there is no such type of element who is going to 0 0 0. Identity, you know that is the universal truth. Identity will map to identity, okay. So you will never count identity, okay. So there is no such type of element who will be go to the identity except identity element, okay. So null space of, it means that null space of this T, that is 0, nothing, okay. So there is no element. Now we will check how to find the range of T, okay. To find the range of T, every time you have to use the same method. So that is the standard basis, that is 1 0 and 0 1 4 r square. So at first we are taking such element x1 x2 is equal to, you have x1 x2 is equal to alpha 1 v1 plus alpha 2 v2, okay. So after then linear combination, okay. So now if you will take t x1 x2, okay, we are just using linear transformation, that is the scalar alpha, then t v1 plus alpha 2 t v2, that is the vector, okay. Let the vector is identity. Let the vector is identity. This is E1, this is E2, or you can say that is the V1 or that is the V2. So in this condition what will happen, T that is 1, 0 and alpha 2, that is T, that is 0 and 1, V1 and V2, okay. If we'll put 1, 0, then what will happen, then you will get 1, 0, you are getting 1, okay. Then 1 0 you are getting 1 0 you are getting 0 plus alpha 2 0 1 0 1 means you are getting 1 0 1 it means that you are getting minus 1 0 1 it means that you are getting 1. So you have this, okay. So now Now you have such type of result, okay, and after then you can solve by two by the help of two method, either just multiply it and after then solve, or put the value here 1 1 0, convert this this to a matrix, okay, then 1 minus 1 1, okay. You know that it is not possible to all the element 0, and here also it is not possible to all the element will be 0, okay. So it means that this line that is linearly independent, that line is also linearly independent, all element are not 0. So rank of this first type of matrix is equal to 2. It means that rank of 2 means total number of two variables, that is free, okay. So free variables are 2, it means that free variables are 2, it means that rank of range, sorry, dimension of range, that is 2, okay. This is the method, okay. Now we are just coming in the second question, then again I will try to explain everything, okay. I am coming in a good question that will explain actually what we are doing, okay. So come in the next, I am just erasing it. Now friends, this is the next question. He has asked T of x1, x2, x3 is equal to this. So here T is mapping R3 to R3, okay. So you can see that there are total number of 3, first vector, second vector, first variable, second variable, third variable. So total number of 3 variable, it means that R3, total number 3 variable, that is R3, okay. So now again, let e1 is equal to standard vector, again we are taking e2 is equal to 0 1 0 and e3 is equal to 0 0 1, okay. The shortcut method I will just explain you. So if you will put here t 1 0 0, then what will happen, you will get 0 0, then you will get 14, 14 into 1 is equal to 14, 17 into 1 is equal to 17, other are 0, 3 into 1 is equal to 3, okay. So you got 14, 17 and 3. If we'll put 0, 1, 0, then after then other will be 0, only x2 will be safe because of 1. So you are getting 17, that is 26 and that is 9, okay. Now t 0, 0, 1, okay. After then third value it will be safe, other will be 0 because of x1, x2, 0. So you are getting 3 into 1 is equal to 3. Then you are getting 9, okay. Then you are getting 6, okay. So at first you have to place the standard basis in this function, whatever you have got the result, okay. So that result, it will be converted to a matrix. How will you use this matrix? You will use this 14, 17, 3, then after then 17, 26, 9, then you will get 3, 9, 6, okay. Now you have to just convert this matrix to echelon form, okay. So at first I am writing R2 minus R1, okay. It means that this minus this, this is 14, 17 and 3. 17 minus 14 is equal to 3, or 26 minus 17 is equal to 9, and 9 minus 3 is equal to 6. So this 9, this, okay. Then after then you can see that R3 is equal to R3 minus R2, okay. Then you are getting, this is R3, this is R2. Then you are getting this 14 and 17 and 3, this 396, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. You can see that this row, it will be never 0, this row, it will be never 0. One row is 0, okay. So if two row that is not 0, it means that dimension of this t is equal to 2, okay. So that is the way to find the range of t, okay. We find here the range of t, that is the way to find the range of t. Whenever you have to find the range of t, then you will use the standard basis. You will put the standard basis here, whatever you have got, you got a matrix, then try to just convert this matrix to echelon form, okay. In this echelon form, check that its rank, okay, its rank is 2, then range okay, range of this matrix, this linear transformation is 2, okay. So range of this linear transformation is 2, okay, or you can say rank is 2, range is 2, okay. So now again our next task, so what is the nullity? Nullity means I told you that how many elements are going to 0, okay, this element, let just we are taking that this element is going to 0, it means that this element will be 0, 0, 0, it is going to 0. So this is 0, this is 0, this is 0. So you are getting 14x1 plus 17x2 plus 3x3 is equal to 0 first, and 17x1 plus 26x2 plus 9x3 is equal to 0. Third is 3x1 plus 9x2 plus 6x3 is equal to 0. By the help of high school, you can solve it. What is the value of x1, x2, x3? Or how many free variables are here? Okay. That will be clear your concept. Now I am just giving you another example, another method. Okay. That is the first method. I am just giving you second method. What will you do in the second method? Okay. So you will convert this one to matrix form. So this time you have 14, 17 and 3, then 17 and 26 and 9, then 3, then 9 and 6. Okay, you have this matrix. Okay, again in this matrix you can see, again you will try to convert this matrix. You can see that both matrix are same. You can see that both matrix are same. If you will just convert this matrix, then after then again this matrix, it will be you will get the same thing. Okay, so in this condition, or you can do also another thing. What you can do? I will do something. Okay, I am just writing here. C3 tends to C3 minus C2. C2 minus C1, okay. I am writing C2 minus C1. So you will get 14, 17, 3, okay. Then after then you are getting 396, okay. Then after then subtract both, then you will get 14, 17, 3. This is 396, this minus this equal to 0, this minus this equal to 0, this minus this equal to 0, okay. So after then what will you do? I am just doing something. I am writing R3 tends to, I am just multiplying minus 3 R2 plus 7 R3, okay. What I am doing, this is R2, this is R3. I am multiplying R2 by 3, okay. And 7 to this, then after then we are subtracting. If we'll do, then this matrix, it will be converted to this form. I am just again writing, okay, R2. What is R2? R2 is this 17, 3 is a 2 and R3. R2 and R3. Okay, I have done something wrong here. That is 17, okay. Then after then we subtract, then we have done something wrong here. What we have done something wrong here. This is actually C2 minus C1. And suppose you are thinking that is the long method. You know that this matrix and this matrix both are same. There's no need to just write like in this manner. I'm just using this old. Okay, I'm erasing it. Whatever we have got before, it was this now. So we convert this to this. Okay, no problem. 14 3 0. 17 9 0 3 6 0, okay. After they multiply this x1 x2 x3 this is equal to 0, 0, 0. Multiply, then after that you will get the same thing. Na? So 14x1 this to this plus 17x2 plus 3x3 is equal to 0. Then this to this. Then 3x1 plus 9x2 plus 3, 6x3. 3 into this, 9 into this, 6 into this. Okay. Is equal to 0. Now you have to solve the both one. Okay. If you just use any method, you can subtract this one. But the both will never subtract. Okay. So it will, you will get something. So one variable it will be free in this condition. One variable it will be free, and one variable it will totally depend on the other. Okay. So it means if you will multiply this one 14 and this equation with 14 and this equation with 3, and this x, this both will be subtracted, and then after then x1 will be cancelled, and you will get something, you will get something. Okay. So you will get alpha into x2. I am not solving. Alpha into x2 is equal to beta into x3. Something you will get. Okay. If you will put any variable, that is free variable. Okay, that is free variable. If you will put any variable, then you will get alpha x2. Okay, x2 is dependent on x3. Okay, but we don't know about x1 because x1 already we have finished. So x1, that is also free variable, and this is also free variable. Okay, we got this is also free variable, and this is also free variable. So before we have two variables are free. But what is the one is the dependent? You can see that. Okay, if two variables are free, then you can say that. What will you say if two variables are free? Okay, so in this condition, dimension of kernel of T is equal to 1. Okay, so you can say that free variable. How many free variable you have to find? Means how many free variables are here? Okay. So this is a very simple question. So I will just, if you have any doubt, I will come in next question. Okay, I am just coming in the next question that will again clear your concept. Maybe you did not get. Maybe it can possible. Okay, that is a late night. Okay, this time the time is 3 a.m. Okay, actually. Okay, I am also trying to just teach you. But this is the best question. Okay, by the help of this question, your concept it will be clear. What we have written, just try to just understand it. Okay, pause the video and try to understand what I am just saying. This is a function. Okay, it is mapping from R4 to R cube. Okay, means there are total number of 4 elements, there are total number of 3 elements. Okay, it means that there are total number of 4 element, okay, and there are total number of 3 element. Okay, means the vector, there are total of 4, and in this vector there are only 3 element. Okay, that is R4 and that is R3. Okay, it is mapping from 4 vector to 3 vector. Okay, so now we have written f of x, y, z, t, 4 element x, y, z, t. Here the element type is this x, y, z and t. Okay, so what the map the means of mapping here, the element type is p, q, r. Its meaning is this: r cube means this, r4 means this. Okay, but the mapping when we are mapping, so we have this condition. Okay, we have to add this 4 element, subtract, something like that. Okay, now we have to prove that we have to find what is the image of f, what is the kernel of f, or nullity and range. Okay, we have to find what is the range, what is the kernel, nullity, what is the image, find the image, find the kernel, both are same. Okay, so how to prove it? Okay, I told you you have to use the basis. So what is the basis for this 1 0 0 0? Okay, I am just again putting 1 0 0 0, that is the standard basis every time you have to put. Then you will get 1 1, this first value 1, the first value 1. Okay, you are getting this. When you will get f 0 0, sorry, this is 1. Okay, the second one 0 0 0. Okay, the second one is 1, So you will get minus 1, you are getting, there is no y, you can see that, okay, then it means that 0, and there is y, it means that 1, okay. So this time you are getting minus 1, 0, 1, okay. Then after then, f 0, 0, 1, 0, okay. Next time, third one is 1, it means that t, e is 1, okay, z is 1, okay, 1, okay, then 2, 2, then z is 1, it means that 3, okay, other rest 0, and the next time 0, 0, 0, 1, you have to put all the value here, okay, that is the answer, okay, so 1, 1 means t is 1, okay, and other 0, and t is 1, it means that minus 1, and t is 1, it means that minus 3, okay. When you put this value, you got this one, okay, in this function, okay, that is the output, okay, this value it is here in the right side, okay, this value it is in left side, okay, so whatever you have got, you will just write in a matrix form, okay, after then your, if you want to find the range, every time you have to, follow our steps, okay, you will write 1, 1, 1, minus 1, 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, and 1, minus 1, minus 3, now you have to find the rank of the matrix, okay, so what will you do, this is the R1, this is the R2, this is the R3, this is the R4, okay, so it must be 0, it must be 0, it must be 0, okay, so what will I do, at first I am adding both, so we are getting 1, 1, 1, that is okay, this plus this is equal to 0, this plus this is equal to 1, this plus this is equal to 2, again I am just adding this and this, 1 plus 1 is equal to 1, 0, this plus this is equal to 2, this plus this is equal to 4, okay, I am adding this, this plus this is equal to 0, this plus this is equal to minus 1, this plus this is equal to minus 2, okay, we got this, now we cannot disturb this one because other are 0, okay, just leave it. Now we have to convert this must be 0, this must be 0. Sorry, okay. So I am just doing 1, 1, 1, it must be 0, okay. This plus this is equal to 0, okay. So this will be same, okay. 0, 1, 2, no problem. Then after then, what we will do. We will multiply by 2 here, okay, then after then, this is R2, we have to change in R2, minus 2, R, sorry, this is R3 minus 2, R2, what is R3, R1, R2, R3, R3 is 0 to 4, R3 is 0 to 4, and R2 is 0, 1, 2, if you multiply by 2, then you are getting 0, 2, 4, okay, again 0 to 4, minus minus minus, then you are getting 0, 0, 0, so R3 is 0, 0, 0, again, if you add this and this, then you will get 0, this and this, then you are getting 0, this and this, you are getting 0, okay, your matrix is this, so it will be never 0, it will be never 0, but both are 0, so in this condition, I am writing here something, does 1 1 1 and 0 1 2, I am writing something that is very important, okay, form a basis for image of f, okay, and dimension of or you can see that range of f is equal to 2, because 2 are not zero, non-zero, it means that the rank of this matrix is equal to 2, okay, range of f means what is the, whenever you are just using the standard basis, or if they have given you the basis, whenever and after you are putting the basis, whatever you are getting, the rank of the matrix is the range of T, range of F, okay, this is the meaning, we got, okay, now, we have to find the kernel of F or null D, we have to find, the second method is we have to find the nullity. What I told you, that nullity means how many elements are going to zero. This is going to zero, it means that if it is going to zero, then this is 0 0 0, so this will be zero, this zero, this zero. It means that you are getting x minus y plus z plus t is equal to zero. Second, x plus 2z minus t is equal to zero. Then you are getting this x plus y plus 3z minus 3t is equal to zero. Now it is high school, solve it, very simple. Okay, solve it, then you will get the result. Okay, and what I am doing, I am just doing this one. Okay, I am just adding this and this. Then after then, what will I get? If I will add it, then x plus x is equal to 2x. I will get 2x, this and this finish, z, and 3z is equal to 4z. Okay, this and this is equal to minus 2t is equal to 0. Okay, now you can see that we have also again another question. We will multiply this by 2, then what we will get? 2x, 2 to the 4, 4z, 2 into 2 minus 2t, okay, is equal to 0. You can see that both are same. Both are same, 0 is equal to 0, something we got. So now, in this condition, what should I do? Okay, in this condition, what should I do? Or we can do also something. What should I do? So we are getting the same value. Okay, this both will be cancelled. I am just writing something. So 2x plus 4z is equal to 2t. Now 2 cancel both sides, then you are getting x plus 2z is equal to t. Now you can see that we got this conclusion. Okay, so we can see that the free variable, if we'll put the two different variable, then this t, it is totally depend on this two free variable. It means that free variable r. Okay, you have three equation, you have to find the solution of such type of equation. Okay, so after that we try to solve it, and after that we got only one equation, because every time we are getting the same equation. So after that we have written in this form. So this t, it is totally depend on this two variable. Okay, if we put two different variable, then the t will come. Okay, so this t is dependent, but both are free variable. So free variable are two. Whenever we are just converting the all element to zero, then the total free variable are two. Okay, so that total free variable are showing that nullity of f is equal to 2. Okay, that is the way to find the solution, how to find the range of t, how to find the nullity of t or kernel of t. Okay, same method you have to apply. They will change the question in your exam. You have to follow only my step to get good marks. Okay, thank you so much. I think that you understand. If you are just facing any problem, then you must ask me. Thank you so much.